Shop Talk.
This is Shop Talk, guys. I am Avria.
And I'm Junior.
And it's just Shop Talk, guys. Shop Talk was created to discuss views and opinions often discussed in a barbershop or a salon setting. We also advertise for businesses, and if you got something juicy going on, hit your girl up, and I'm going to get you on the show. So, let's chop it up, guys.
Let's chop it up.
So today we are, like I said, we come to businesses. So we are chopping it up today and having Shop Talk in an actual shop. And we are chopping it up with Mr. George Jr. at Junior's Barbershop on West Main. I get West Main and West Avenue all mixed up, guys.
It's right there, though. It's like West Main and West Avenue. It's one street, but it's just kind of like, you know, if you're from out of state, you'll get messed up.
Yes.
West Main and West Ave. 615 West Main Street, y'all.
Yes. So we are chopping it up about being submissive, about alpha women being submissive and being overly submissive. So let's chop it up, guys.
Let's chop it up.
Because I seen a post that you posted, and I don't know if you remember it like verbatim, like exactly what you said, but.
Can we go to the post, please?
What? On his page?
Can we go to the post and just get exactly what the post was?
Exactly. But basically, the post, he said, basically, he was saying, you know, if a man is paying the bills, he's taking care of home, he's doing what he's supposed to do, basically, it's okay, like telling us, it's okay for you as women to be submissive to your man. Hey, but where you threw the curveball at, where men usually throw that curveball.
Yeah, we got like three of those.
Where you throw that curveball is where he said, even when it comes to cheating, what did you say about?
When it comes to stepping outside of the relationship.
Even you know, if you know.
Knowing that, you know, we're not perfect, right? And understanding that, right, is giving you the opportunity to really talk about something that just happened in the relationship, and either, you know, A, had an option of dealing with it, or B, you know, having the option of not dealing with it.
Right, but you were saying, in the status, you was basically saying, like, even knowing that he might step out, this now I remember, even knowing that he might step out, still being submissive to that man because he basically takes care of everything. And like you said, the home is basically in his name and he's taking care of the bills there, the car is being taken care of. You was like, basically like, even if you know he's stepping out, you should still be submissive to that man.
Exactly.
Now, as an alpha woman, you know, it's kind of like, well, I don't need you to pay the bills or my mortgage or the rent for the house. I don't need you to pay the car insurance, to take care of the car, just for you to be able to step out of the relationship. But when you broke down stepping out of the relationship, you were saying basically even to converse with a person.
Can I see that? So I can read it. I just want to read it.
Here it is.
I want everybody, you know, verbatim.
Right.
Because I don't know.
Because I'm just breaking down, you know, how I analyzed it or my perception of the stat. But go ahead and read it.
All right. So the stat stated, ladies, if your man is paying all the bills, your car note, your cell phone, and you're living in a house that is also financed by him, at what point do you decide to genuinely submit to that man and allow him to be the head of the relationship, even knowing that he may step outside of the relationship? I said all men do, and vice versa. So that's the debate.
Okay, that's basically it. So my perception number, the way I perceived the stat was right. That was my perception of it, and I agreed with you until you got to the end. As I said, that curveball, that stepping out, because I'm not stepping out of the relationship. If I'm completely happy with you, you know, I'm gonna submit. And what submitting is, and men have to submit to, you know, I think especially for an alpha woman to submit, a man have to submit some as well. So that's being, you know, ways that, you know, I need you to change. Like if you used to come to home 5 o'clock in the morning, right, and I'm telling right. you, okay, baby, I need you to come in at 2. Right. And I see you doing
that. I understand that. I understand that. I wasn't so much as really even thinking about that part of the relationship. I was speaking in terms of stepping out emotionally with another woman, stepping out physically, possibility physically with another woman. You know, it's different stages of stepping out. And so when I say emotional, I may not feel what I feel for you 3 months down the line. I may run into another lady and she may spark something that you did. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So it's ways of stepping out without being physical.
But it's all, like you said, it's all stepping out, though.
It's all stepping out. No matter how you look at it, it's all stepping out.
And I agree
so
with
is
you.
That is that wrong or is that right? It's ground rules that have to be established. So
I mean,
you know, were they established in the beginning of the relationship?
I mean, certain audience. We have a question from the audience member.
Well, no, I was gonna more or less say like
shout out to Tipsy Crew.
Shout out,
got us lit.
But I was more or less gonna say, okay, I don't necessarily think I would be in a situation where he pays for everything. I feel like I would have to contribute in some kind of way, whether I'm helping the business or whether I got my own little something going on. But if, let's just say I am in that situation, I'm talking about that's the type of relationship where you need to wake up with his dick every day. Like, go to sleep, suck
it.
But see, he ain't gonna have no reason to step out because I like big booty bitches. I mean, I'm not gay. I've never been with a woman, but I like big booty bitches. And if my nigga like, yo, let's go get a bitch,
you'll probably try it, right?
Yeah, I probably would.
But see, and that's like, submissive.
I mean, but that's my nigga, though. Like, he not putting nobody in front of me. Like, we Christmas, Thanksgiving, we with the kids. Like, bitches, no. Like, bitch, you might have sucked that dick, but bitch, you better not call my nigga.
Can we get her a chair?
Right.
Can we get her a chair?
Bitch, you better leave that
like that.
Car.
He's with.
Can we get her a chair?
No, I think it's because I have a race. Because I grew up with Italian side. Like my papi, he cheated, but he never brought that phone in the house. The bitches never showed up at the house and never disrespected my grandma. No, none of that. She never knew this nigga cheated.
And see,
you know, and you know me, I've been in a situation where I had to find out from the laptop and the cell phone when I was fighting the case, like, oh, he was cheating with all these bitches?
How? See,
I don't want to have to go for that. I want my nigga to be able to tell me everything.
See, if I'm being submissive, if I'm being completely submissive, I don't think it should be no reason for you to be stepping out emotionally as an alpha woman. Like, and this is where pride come in at, because it's like I'm breaking myself down and I'm submitting to you, and no matter how hard I submit, no matter how much I change or grow or alter, it's not enough to make you completely be 100% focused on me, like as I'm focused on you.
So
what's the reason to completely submit? And what I mean by that is certain things we really don't be wanting to like tone down, like business. And our time is like, I need to be here like 16 hours out of the day and I don't wanna tone it down and I do it. And you still out here on the phone with this chick texting or in the inbox. And it's like, no matter what I do now, I'm showing you more attention and you're still doing it. So it's kind of like, for an alpha woman to submit and you still stepping out, even not even emotionally, just you know, a little, it's a big fucking deal.
Hey, and you know, I just want to say this.
It's a big deal.
I agree with you 100%, and I just want to commend you for not having that bad spirit.
What bad spirit?
What are we talking about now?
What
of expecting your mate to not go out and
you should always hold your mate to that regard.
And so right, but
you should always hold him to that regard. But look, I mean, be
We need to get her his hair.
But it's
real. These niggas be told these.
I think that, and so going back, let's just say on the spiritual level, when Adam was told by Eve that you should make something to cover your private area, he didn't know he had a private area until she told him, right? Because God put us on the planet how he put us on the planet to be pure. But all of that, and so with all of the impurities that we inherited, right, up until 2020, right, everybody didn't inherit the same one. And so that's why, you know, going back, a sin is a sin, no matter how small and how big. And so, what going back to my thoughts on why women should be submissive, I think that's a chain effect.
I think it's an excellent trait.
I think it's a wonderful trait.
For the right person.
Yeah, to me.
I think it's a beautiful trait because within myself, like, I see growth, and the older I get, the more submissive I get because I'm growing and I'm learning that it's not such a bad thing when you're with the right person that brings it out of you or can bring it out of you in a proper way. And I think submissive to a woman to me is making sure you're fed, making sure your clothes is clean, making sure the
house. Now when you say making sure you're fed how?
Mentally, spiritually, emotionally, of course, fed food wise, you know what I mean? But fed, you know? And not in the sense saying putting you first, but making you a priority. And with an alpha woman, you know, that's major. And I think with a man, if he's really paying attention, you see submission, being a woman being submissive. You know, you getting up, the breakfast is hot, what you want to eat, lunch, what you want for lunch. Do you want a lunch? Oh no, you're good. Okay, well what's for dinner? You know, those are things that's covered. And then the clothes, the house, and then from that is anything else emotionally that you may need. But again, we do all of this and it's still not enough.
It's like,
you know?
It's like, let me tell you, hold on,